Japanese ambassador, His Excellency Masahiro Mura, Bulumilaka, the resident representative of the Fiji JICA office, the 5S Kaizen Total Quality Management experts and facilitators, the acting permanent secretary for health and medical services. Might be the last time we'll see you for a little while. And the senior managers in the Ministry of Health. Thank you all for the opportunity to join you here today. And I want to start by congratulating all of us, and especially Divisional Medical Officer Western and the Medical Superintendent, and also the Subdivisional Team in Nandi for the outstanding work that we did in looking after the ADB meeting. And also my thank yous to all the subdivisions around the West for pitching in and supporting the work. And I hear Dr. Pablo was down in Nandi during that time. So thank you all very much. When I was thinking about the 5S Kaizen and total quality management, this is a very good example of how we're able to come to the fore. We have a significant up to $3 million renovation already completed in Nandi Hospital. Already people are calling me and telling me how exciting and how beautiful Nandi is, and also the change that's happened within the staff that work in that area, and how during the ADB meeting, our staff and our corporate and also our health professionals held themselves up in high regard. So thank you all very much. I also like to congratulate our staff that was seconded to the meeting, the drivers and also the vehicles, and so we've contributed to the meeting in a way that Fiji has now shown that he can actually participate and also host a meeting of such caliber. And that is the role in which we, the Minister of Health, participate in. Today marks an important milestone for us as a ministry, and because we are partnering with JICA. And this is not the first time that we've been partnering with JICA in mechanisms to ensure that we have a stronger health system, but also in terms of the areas around quality and quality management. We've heard about total quality management, the 5S Kaizen, and the implementation period for this is 3 years in selected sites around Fiji. And they are the FPBS, Fiji Pharmacy and Biomedical Services. And again, I'd like to congratulate the head of FPBS for some of the good work that they've been doing recently. CWM Hospital, and also thank CWM for bearing with some of the difficult challenges, some of the difficult decisions that we've had to make to protect the lives of our people. Lambasa Hospital, Valilevu Health Center, Nosori Maternity Hospital, Nosori Health Center, and Singota Hospital. I also thank the 5S Kaizen TQM and also JICA for bearing with us, because when they came initially, Valilevu was not on the list. And I insisted and asked that we had Valilevu included, and I'm very grateful that the Valilevu team is also here today. This 5S Kaizen TQM was introduced early in 2007 under the JICA's Group and Regional Training Program in Fiji. And two of our nurses from CWM Hospital Lotoka attended the meeting in 2016 on 5S Continuous Quality Improvement held in Sri Lanka. The interest continues to grow bigger and stronger as the need for more quality care escalates around Fiji. Under this new project, we have the JICA experts here who have been dispatched to Fiji with their wealth of knowledge and experience in the implementation of this unique system in many other countries, and for that we are truly grateful to the Japanese government for this support. The same expertise and support is expected as the project is introduced into the system to support the ministry in improving health services around Fiji. And I was very interested in the opening remarks that His Excellency talked about this morning about quality circles in the Toyota company back when they started. And we all know the high standards in which the Toyota company holds itself. And I believe this has been because of a continuous improvement and continuous quality circles that they've worked on over the years. And they've reached that level of standard. I extend my appreciation to JICA for working close collaboration with the ministry in the organization of this meeting. and for supporting the participation of our senior managers. 5S Kaizen TQM originated in the operational management in Japanese manufacturing industry. However, in the recent years, the focus has shifted from the manufacturing industry to the cutting edge emergency care providers, providers and businesses that seek to champion customer satisfaction at its core. Today, the objective of this approach is to transfer the value co-creation activities or service into the healthcare and medical services. In the year 2000, Dr. Wimal Karantagonda, director of Castle Street Hospital in Sri Lanka, first applied the industrial tool in the health sector. He invented the stepwise approach from 5S Kaizen, then to total quality management. We've heard that Kaizen is a Japanese word for continuous quality improvement. It is a change for the better. And a change for the better needs to be spread throughout the Ministry of Health and Medical Services and become the dominant culture. There is no better place to start with and with us as leaders, because a change inside this room will have a ripple effect across divisions and sections throughout our ministry. We have to be strong, we're going to be mentally strong. We have to be leaders in the real version of leadership. And when I think about what we do and the fact that you are here as leaders of divisions, one thing that comes to my mind is the fact that you are captains of a ship in stormy weather. And at the end of the day, you will have to make the decision. And sometimes the decision has to be difficult decisions. Sometimes you have to go down to the bottom of your ship to encourage those who are bailing water out. But that is the role that we will have to play. And in the health sector, there's always been a mismatch between demand and supply of resources. But I'm pleased to say that over the last few years, the government, the Fiji First government, has been working very strongly to ensure that we have newer facilities, that we renovate some of the current facilities that we have, and we improve on our supply and demand chain. All of the problems that are there in the hospitals, in the divisions, can be solved by the people who run it. And I have complete faith in that. One thing that I also realize, that 80% is system and 20% are people. So at the end of the day, we're going to make sure that we strengthen the system and address the issues that management frontline are, where we are the leaders in that regard. TQM is a multidisciplinary and participatory process which optimizes all categories of activities in all departments, units and staff for realizing high quality services and care. It must be part of the institution managerial framework for seeking high quality productivity and service delivery inside our ministry. As a ministry, we're looking towards a change for the better. And a change for the better needs continuous improvement and commitment from the entire workforce. Can I just add in this regard that one thing I believe that we haven't done very well is telling the story. And I think what we need to do is actually spend time, a lot of time with our staff at the coalface and tell them the story of the journey, where we are and where we want to go. And that is one thing that I've challenged myself over the last 4 months in traveling throughout the breadth of the land in which we serve and visiting all the facilities, talking to staff, telling them about the story. When I was in New Zealand on the weekend, I had a group of former Fiji citizens, doctors, nurses who turned up, quite a lot of them, friends of Fiji Health. I sat down with them for over 3 hours and told them the story, because I think it was important that we all know what the story is, what the dream is, what the vision is. And TQM can only be successful if we are able to tell them the story, that they understand where we are going, they understand the destination, they understand that there will be storms of life, but the change that happens will be for the better, and it's a change of mindset and a change of attitude. And the change begins with us. I urge you, all of us today, including myself, to embrace the change, for as we lead, the future is beckoning us to be better. Remember, the future just doesn't arrive, it is actually built. Toyota is a company that is of world renown, and it's happened because they've worked hard on quality management. So I encourage us all today to embrace to register ourselves as breeders of leaders that will actually bring change for the people of Fiji. Thank you, Nawalewu, and God bless you.